This is an important video, so it will be discussing the status of my channel. It will be discussing the status of things going on around us. If you are in the mood to spam my comments with love and bullshit, I don't really care. Don't worry. I love you too. But let me get across with this stuff first. Alright, my dudes? Alright. Why did I make this channel? Many will ask. Why have you come to YouTube to express hate towards many people? Why have you come to talk shit about people? And I have the response of, because I want to say what I want to say. The new generations have become totally fucked. I'm not one of those people saying, oh, I was born in the wrong generation. I grew up listening to King Kong slapping his nuts against rocks. No. What the whole problem is I think we've become sensitive, illiterate pussies. Hear me out. People go through their problems. Everybody has their problems. I have my problems, most definitely. But the whole problem is that nobody knows how to deal with their own problems without trying to seek empathy from everybody else. I don't make videos like these for empathy. I don't talk to you guys because I feel bad and I want you guys to feel bad with me. I want you guys to know that I feel bad and the next video might not be a while from it. But allow me to explain the status of the channel. 198 subscribers. I can't thank you guys enough. I don't know how I could thank you more. We're almost to 200 and I just hope we keep going from there. But I really am losing my motivation to do these videos. And to be honest, I've been trying so hard to keep going. But what ends up in the day is I feel like my videos are for nothing. My voice isn't heard. But I want you guys to know that no matter what, even if I'm losing my motivation, I do it all for you. I want you guys to hear the most vulgar garbage. I want you guys to laugh when I scream about Yandere Dev being a pedophile cunt. I want you guys to be happy. I want you guys to enjoy my content. I mean, there are some videos you might not enjoy, but let me keep going with this. Yeah, you'll be interested, don't worry. People become angry or upset. They drive themselves to forget about these moments when they reached a point where they don't like themselves or whatnot. It's called being depressed, if you didn't know. And what ends up happening is these people don't solve their problems the right way. People will do it destructively, people will do it, you know, whatnot. I think that the way the world is solving their problems now is awful. We have become dumbasses. If I don't like something and it makes me upset, I can just say, it does this, and YouTube's like, we're so sorry, please allow us to demonetize and take this video down because you reported it for a false thing. This is not how YouTube should be run. What I'm saying, YouTube can blow me. I don't like YouTube. It's good for platform for me to post my videos, but the people who run it are genuinely not good. Apologies to any YouTube staff watching this. Chances are that's not going to happen, but you can suck my cock. Because, like, are you serious? You're going to demonetize and deplatform people just because they have a different opinion or a different idea from you, or they hurt your feelings a little, is dumb. I don't give five fucks about your feelings. You can suck my dick, as I said. The whole problem is that you're not getting the message from your own users. You're not hearing, hey, can you stop demonetizing my favorite YouTuber for bullshit? I mean, also, can you fix your fucking rules? This isn't a child-friendly site, so don't make it one. If kids want to watch YouTube, they go on YouTube Kids. I don't give a flying fuck about my goddamn vulgar vocabulary. I'm not changing for your rhetoric. I'm not changing just for you. What I will do is I will stay vulgar, I will speak my mind, and I will speak my opinion, because that's what matters to me. I want people to hear what I have to say. I want people to understand what I have to say. I want people to compare what I have to say to an opposition and wonder if I'm true, if I'm correct in what I say. And that's fine by me. I want people to do that. I want people to question. You know who I like? Now, I'm gonna make a call out. Eating the Cannibals. Now, of course, you might be wondering, who is this top lad? Who is this Chad of a human being? Eating the Cannibals does things differently. He's a political channel, and he talks about politics. And I like this guy. You know why? Because he's managed to get successful, and from being small to jumping to 2,000 subscribers. He's done a good job, and he did it organically. I want to do my channel organically. I don't want to feed and advertise my channel. I don't want to be a scumbag. And the whole problem is that I feel like I'm being crushed by YouTube's algorithms. Because not saying like, people should enjoy my content. I just think that there's probably some people out there who probably would enjoy my content. But the problem is there's no area for people like us to go. So what ends up happening is we kind of enter this void space where YouTube's casting all these YouTubers who want to make it big here, but they just can't, really. So what ends up happening is we hit this null void. We don't exist. And you know why? Because they push us down on purpose. Who is the most popular one right now? Vox? Yeah, they got popular. T-Series? Those two got popular because YouTube wanted them to get popular. Vox, I'm pretty sure, was actually a pretty shitty news site at the start, and they were mainly pushed by other people with the same ideologies, and they tried to push them up because they're super extremist. And the thing is, I don't like that. If YouTube wants to do that, fuck you. Fuck you, YouTube. You can't just take other people's rights away and then say, well, we treat other users fairly. They're a company. They don't give a shit about your opinion. They don't give five flying fucks about what you had to say. What they do care about is that sweet dollar bill. They don't give two fucks. I really wish they did. I wish they cared about their users, but no. Let's ban Ben Shapiro. Let's ban Steven Crowder. Let's ban The Daily Wire. Hell, InfoWars while we're at it. Hell, let's ban the entire whoever doesn't agree with me. There's people on this website who get banned for dumbass reasons. And I think that we as the users need to speak up. Our opinion matters. People don't speak up because YouTube is this big corporation. But if enough people start talking about it and enough people expose YouTube for the shitty scum they are, what happens is they have to listen. So if people were to say, hey, you know, you, I want to tell you, you're a fucking idiot. This is why you're a fucking idiot. And this is how you need to change so you're not a fucking idiot and how you're not screwing other people over. That person will listen because I'm directly talking to them. I'm directly saying, you need to stop. You're being an idiot. With YouTube, they're like 1,000 people. So you're going to need 1,000 people to go and directly say, stop being a fucking idiot. You're a fucking idiot. Stop. This won't happen because people are scared to confront a giant company that they are platformed on because they don't want to get demonetized and have their whole life ruined. And this brings me to the problem. People's lives are being ruined because of these things. Because of these ginormous companies just deciding, you know, we have a monopoly on this shit. You don't need money because you have a different opinion. Nope. Demonetize. Comment awards. I don't know what the fuck they did, but they got demonetized anyways. I think it was from one of their memes, but they just get their whole channels demonetized for dumb shit reasons. And you know what? I hate that. I don't like when free speech is silenced in the midst of the thunder. I think that everyone's voice matters. It doesn't matter if you're somebody like Yandere Dev. You have a voice. Let it ring. I don't give a shit if your opinion differs from mine. I'm not going to intentionally deplatform you just because I don't like you. I'm gonna deplatform you. I mean, even though I might want to deplatform Yandere Dev, I don't like him. But would I? Hell no! Because he has a voice. I wouldn't take down his channel for $1 million. Debatable, but it's so fun to make fun of him that I feel there would be no need. I would enjoy every second of screaming at a camera and saying, "You're a fucking idiot, just saying." And it's fun. It's really fun. And I love to do it. I do it for you, and I would do it again. I would do it over and over again. Just for you guys. But YouTube, they want to say, "Hey, you know, your dedication, I don't give a shit about it. I don't give a flying fuck. Fuck you. I'm going to demonetize everything. I'm going to take away your I'm going to take away everything you love and care about and leave you homeless." This is what YouTube is doing to YouTube creators right now. And you know what? I'm fucking sick of it. I watch videos and I say, "Huh, why is this person not higher on the..." Oh, the algorithms. That's right. The algorithms are so fucked. Whoever's big gets pushed to the top. Now, I'm not saying communism, but I'm saying there should be an area for YouTube where you can see smaller YouTubers. You can look around in the world of the small YouTube gallery. The people who are low, like me. I'm very small in the charts. I'm 198. People like Eating the Cannibals. People like Taco Christian, or whoever he was. Those people should have some recognition. Because, like, Eating the Cannibals makes some great content. He's not recognized enough because the algorithms fuck him. And, to be honest, I think that if YouTube was to fix all this dumb shit, they would have a viable platform. So, it's the summer, so I'll try to put out some more videos, hopefully. I'm planning on talking about some people, you know, talking smack as usual. And I hope you guys are there for it. I will see you guys later. Some Weird Pace Gaming, out. And Filthy Frank voice will return. It's just, my throat hurts, so, you know. It'll be back, don't worry.